were notified. Charles Vail and Paul Siever were from Fresno. Both their fathers said they would fly to Los Angeles the following morning. We first interrogated the boys separately without success. 11:40 p.m., we began questioning all three of them together.
These were found on the floor of the truck.
Was it mine?
Asparagus seeds.
I bought them and paid for them. I suppose you're going to make a federal case out of it.
I talked to Vollmer. He wants to come down in the morning. I said it'd be all right.
Who's that?
He owns a grocery store that was burglarized. He saw two of the kids.
And you're going to let him take a look at us?
That's right.
It'd be a waste of time.
Well, we've got lots of it. Now tell us about the sporting goods store.
Well, that ought to be obvious even to you. Especially after the other fuzz told you all about it.
You tell us. Who were the other kids? The arresting officer said there were at least six others. You were driving the truck. You blocked the alley with it. The rest of them got away in a blue 64 Pontiac sedan.
Oh, now we both know.
You stole 14 sleeping bags and 14 air mattresses. What were you going to do with them?
Now look, I'll save you some trouble. We're not going to tell you anything you don't already know. And we're not going to tell you anything about anybody else.
Is that right?
You can turn blue before you get anything out of us.
Paul, Charles, I talked to your parents.
Yeah? They have some?
They say you haven't been home for 2 months. Where have you been staying?
I've been staying with him.
Where's that?
Around.
Where's your pad?
The world. The universal refuge of human kindness and love.
That's some address.
The best.
A little tough getting mail, isn't it?
Your parents are worried about you.
So?
You're not concerned?
I can give you the whole bit word for word. I wrote to them. Use one of those mail forwarding services you see in the ads. I don't see why they're so worried.
What do they call you, Charlie? Chuck?
The old man calls me Chuck. I like Charlie. You know, it's kind of amusing watching you guys.
That right?
Yeah, trying to act friendly, get in with us, con us. It's pretty clumsy, though.
Think so? Who's Cleco? Was Vernon with you tonight?
I don't know. He didn't say.
All right, come on down and land. You people are in big trouble here. We've got you made on this hardware store, and you know what that can mean.
We thought about this possibility. We expect the power structure's gonna try to retaliate against us.
It'll delay things, of course.
But not much. And it's not gonna stop it. It's gonna happen with or without us.
What's gonna happen?
I don't think I'll tell you.
Where'd you get the truck?
Oh, I borrowed it.
You mean you stole it?
No, borrowed is the word.
The registered owner's James B. Perkins.
Have you borrowed it from him before?
Yeah.
How often?
As often as we needed it. Perk's one of the good folks. Perk's all right. The usual distortion of social values, no perception.
Perception of what?
If you have to ask, Pops, you ain't got any either.
What were you gonna do with the rifles you stole?
Shoot 'em, man.
At what?
But not at people.
I know how your minds work. You're conditioned. We've rejected the concept of violence.
Except sometimes, like pushing an old man around.
We were just gonna shoot animals. Goats, pigs, that sort of thing.
You know how to handle a rifle, do you?
That's right.
You have guns at home?
No, I learned.
Where did you learn?
I learned, man. I learned, that's all. Right, that's all. No more dialogue. We don't have to talk to you. We got rights, even here.
Especially here.
Hey, you better believe it.
How about other people?
Huh?
Do they have rights?
Well, like, what do you mean?
Like the people you stole from.
Well, that was more important.
How do you figure?
Well, because we're right and they're wrong. They're rotten. All society is. All of you. Rights? Don't make me sick. Oh, yeah, there's a lot of talk about them, sure. But what's going on? What are people doing? That's what counts. Corruption, hypocrisy. You say one thing out of the corner of your mouth and then turn right around and do whatever you can get away with as long as it pays. Look around. You wouldn't see it, would you? Nah, you're part of it. You helped make it that way. Poverty, oppression, moral bankruptcy. Aggression, suppression, the ghettos. And what happens when people try and demand their rights? How you hit them over the head? And then you take what's going on in Vietnam. If that doesn't turn your stomach. Well, we have renounced your whole lousy materialistic society. You're wrong. Now, how does that grab you, Mr. High and Mighty Fuzz?
Not much.
Who's going to run the boat?
What boat?
Well, there aren't any pigs or goats around here, except on some of the offshore islands. In the next few days, this bunch you run with is going to have to steal a boat, aren't they?
You think you got it all worked out, don't you, Sherlock? Well, you don't. What's involved here is a concept so pure, so sophisticated in its simplicity that you'd never understand it. You just don't communicate, man.
Yeah, well, I understand one thing. You'd better start communicating with us, and right now. Because when you come up for a hearing, no judge is going to take the time to listen to all your wise talk. Now, it's your choice. You want to do it the hard way, that's fine. Let's quit for the night. I'm getting bored.
You wouldn't be so bored if you'd understand.
Understand what? That you're a bunch of young would-be toughs that would still be on a stealing spree if you hadn't been caught? What's there to understand?
Tell him.
You know we took an oath.
I, for one, don't want to be considered a common garden variety thief. What we're doing is above all that. I say we tell him and straighten him out.
Yeah, it might be better. Why don't you tell him why, Charlie? Oh, we come down here. Paul and me. I mean, I couldn't take it to school anymore.
School? Now, there's a real conveyor belt to conformity. And my family, no values. You talk about poverty of the spirit? Man, we come here looking for something, we found Denny and these other kids. They're just like us, the same ideas. And I mean, they're beautiful people, and we could talk to them. We cut right through all the false values. So we drew up a compact, an agreement. And it says it all there in the beginning. We do hereby freely bind ourselves in love, each one to the other, and dedicate ourselves to the attainment of freedom of expression without qualification for the human spirit and to the total renunciation of material values.
Beginning to make sense?
Not so far.
Man, we've organized a new society, a new order of things, a perfect order. And the key to it is getting rid of materialism. Nobody owns anything. Everybody owns everything.
Who else is in this with you?
End of the line.
Where do you plan to set up this utopia?
We got a place.
Where?
I can't tell you that.
You got it all worked out.
That's right. A perfect form of government.
Nobody's ever made it work.
We will.
No, you won't.
Why not?
You haven't got perfect people.
Mistake.
I don't know. Maybe part of it's the fact that you're in a hurry. You've grown up on instant orange juice. Flip a dial, instant entertainment. Dial seven digits, instant communication. Turn a key, push a pedal, instant transportation. Flash a card, instant money. Shove in a problem, push a few buttons, instant answers. But some problems you can't get quick answers to, no matter how much you want them. We took a little boy into Central Receiving Hospital yesterday. He was 4 years old. He weighs 8.5 pounds. His parents just haven't bothered to feed him. Now give me a fast answer to that one. One that'll stop that from ever happening again. And if you can't settle that one, what about the 55,000 Americans who will die on the highways this year? That's nearly 6 or 7 times the number that'll get killed in Vietnam. Why aren't you up in arms about that? Or is dying in a car somehow moral? Tell me how to wipe out prejudice. I'll settle for just the prejudices you have inside yourselves. Show me how to get rid of the unlimited capacity for human beings to make themselves believe that they're somehow right and justified in stealing from somebody or hurting somebody. And you just about put this place here out of business.
I don't think that we're telling you to lose your ideals or your sense of outrage. They're the only way things ever get done. And there's a lot that still needs doing. And we hope you'll tackle it. You don't have to do anything dramatic like trying to come up with a better country. You can find enough to keep you busy right here. While you're at it, don't break things up in the name of progress or crack a placard stick over somebody's head to help him see the light. Be careful of his rights, because your property and your person and your rights aren't any better than his. And next time, you may be the one to get it. We remember a man who killed 6 million people and called it social improvement.
So hang in. Don't try to build a new country. Make the old one work. It has for over 400 years. And by the world's standards, that's hardly more than yesterday.
Wow.